In this video, we're going to explore the differences between solid-state and relay outputs on PLC Digital Output Modules. We're also going to talk about the pros and cons of each. The purpose of a PLC output module is to operate or control a physical device based on field device conditions connected to an input module and decisions made by the PLC program. Before we get into solid state and relay PLC outputs, let's clear up the difference between a digital output module, or DO, and an analog output module, or AO. Digital or discrete devices have only two possible conditions. As examples, these two possible conditions could be on or off, open or closed, or energized or de-energized. Analog devices are a bit more complicated because they have an infinite number of possible conditions. To illustrate, we said earlier that a fan is a digital device if it can be turned either on or off. But what if the fan can be adjusted for any speed from off to on? In that case, the fan is an analog device because it has an infinite number of possible speeds. Okay, now that we've clarified the difference between digital and analog devices, let's dig deeper into PLC digital output modules. There are two types of PLC digital output modules, solid state and relay. When PLCs were first introduced, the only outputs were relay type with a separate relay dedicated to each output. As with any typical relay, the PLC output module had physical coils and relay contacts contained inside. The contacts were operated by applying a voltage to the relay coil. The contacts were connected to an external supply to turn on or off a discrete device. Not much has changed, except today's modules have miniaturized relays and contacts. Let's look at an example of an industrial PLC relay output module. The Allen Bradley 1756 OW16I has 16 individual relay outputs. Let's use two of the outputs to operate loads. We can use one output to operate an AC load and another output to operate a DC load, as relay contacts are voltage independent. That's one advantage of relay type, as solid state type output modules are not voltage independent. Relay output modules are available with single pole double throw, or SPDT outputs, as well as seen on the Allen Bradley 1756 OX8I module. Solid state output modules are often referred to as switching modules. Output devices are turned on or off by using solid state devices such as a bipolar junction transistor, or BJT, or a Triac. As we said earlier, the transistor output module is voltage dependent and can only operate DC loads, unlike a relay output module that is happy to operate AC or DC loads. It's important that the load power supply is connected with the correct polarity, as the module can be either sinking type or sourcing type. Sinking and sourcing are terms used to describe the load current flow relative to the output module. We'll take you through an in-depth explanation of sinking and sourcing in another video. The Siemens 6ES7322-1BP50-0AA0 is a 64 output transistor output module. As with all transistor output modules, it can control DC loads only. Let's look at how one of the outputs operates. When the PLC signal is applied, the BJT will turn on and provide a current path for the load. If you want to order this PLC module to use in your projects, you can find the link in the video description. The Phoenix Contact AXL SE-DO16-1 is a 16-output transistor output module. This module has additional features of overload and short circuit protection of outputs and peripheral voltage. Again, you can find the link in the video description if you want to order this PLC module online. The Siemens 6ES 7522-5FF00-0 AB0 is an 8-output Triac output module. A Triac output module is capable of controlling AC loads, where transistor output modules can control DC loads only. When the PLC signal is applied, the Triac will turn on and provide an alternating current path for the load. You can find the link to order this PLC module in the video description as well. After exploring the operation of the relay and solid-state output modules, the obvious question is, which module is best for my application? Here are a few characteristics of each to help you make that decision. Relays generally have a higher current rating than transistors, but as with any mechanical device, it will wear out with time. A relay module can operate AC or DC loads, or both. Relays provide electrical isolation between the load and the PLC. Relays are slow-acting, with typical response times of 10 milliseconds or greater. Closed relay contacts are almost 0 ohms, thus ensuring no voltage loss. Transistor output modules are for DC applications only. Transistors typically cannot switch a large load current, as can a relay. A transistor is fast because there are no mechanical parts. Their response time is much faster than relays. Because a transistor is not a perfect switch, there's always a small voltage drop across it when turned on. In some transistor modules, there is a leakage current even when turned off. A Triac output is used to control AC loads only. As with the transistor, a Triac is much faster than a relay. Triac outputs are suited to low-power AC loads, such as lighting, motor starters, and contactors, with current ratings around 1 amp. Okay, let's review what we've covered in this video. The purpose of a PLC output module is to operate or control a physical device based on field device conditions connected to an input module and decisions made by the PLC program. Digital or discrete devices have only 2 possible conditions, whereas analog devices have an infinite number of possible conditions. There are 2 types of PLC digital output modules: solid state and relay. Solid state modules include transistor and Triac types. Want to learn PLC programming in an easy to understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realpars.com.